Your game is going to look awesome on the big screen. But before we look towards the future, let's start with a trip to the past. First, you need to be aware of something called overscan when you're designing your game. Overscan refers to a problem with many older and some modern TVs. Basically, some older CRTs had trouble centering images, and there was some variability in how different models did it. The solution was to center an image as best they could, and then slightly enlarge it to make sure it would take up the whole screen. Unfortunately, this meant that the edges of the image would sometimes be cut off. So here, for example, our Android's feet might not be visible. Surprisingly, even modern flat-screen TVs suffer from this problem, although for different technical reasons and to a lesser degree. Here's what to do. I'd recommend establishing a safe zone for important content. Your best bet is to avoid placing important screen elements within about 5% from each edge of the display. 5% is a rough guideline, and that's because the overscan amount varies on different televisions. Here's how that might look on a 1080 pixel screen. We could add a 96 pixel margin on the left and right edges, and a 54 pixel margin on the top and bottom edges. This is just for illustration. Check out the instructor notes for more details on the specific margins you should add. If you're designing a TV app, then you don't need to worry about overscan if you're using the leanback fragments. For example, the browse fragment you see here automatically applies overscan margins to your layouts. If you're building a game that will run on both a mobile device and a TV, then at runtime, you might want to detect what type of device you're running on so you can adjust how the screen space is used. You can do this using the UI Mode Manager, and there's more details on this in the Building TV Apps section of this course.